Sister asked the question that can we consider DNA test in case of adultery, in case of rape also, you said, sister?
Yes, brother.
Fornication instead of four witnesses. See, what is mentioned in the Quran that fornication is prohibited. If you want to give a punishment, four witnesses required. That's compulsory. From DNA testing, you can come to know who is the person involved, but yet, there are other fallacies that are there. Whether fornication is taking place or not, the DNA testing can be an additional support. DNA testing can be used for rape cases. According to Islamic Sharia, a person who is a rapist should be put to death, according to a Sahih Hadith. But if you don't find four witnesses in case of rape, in this case solitary witness is sufficient, it can further be substantiated by DNA testing also for rape, but not for fornication. For fornication, it can be an additional proof, but by itself, DNA testing only cannot be sufficient for fornication. Point number one, for a fornication but natural, it should be that both should agree. So both should agree for the haram act, then it is a fornication or adultery. If one person forces on the other, it becomes rape. So in cases of a criminal act, like forcing, then DNA testing alone is also sufficient. But if it's an agreement of both, then four witnesses is a must. Because you tell me one thing, if two people are there who have been involved in adultery, if they have been involved in adultery, and suppose someone lays an allegation that X and Y are doing adultery, let's do their DNA testing. Why should they agree? So to let a DNA test be done, you again require four witnesses. Because it's laying an allegation against the modesty. The moment I'm doing a DNA test, that means I'm doubting that person's modesty. So to lay an allegation, Quran says four witnesses. So if you doubt Mr. X and Miss Y are involved in adultery or fornication, so first you require four witnesses to do the test. So even if four witnesses, whether the test comes true or not, that is sufficient. To substantiate, you can do the test and prove it. But point number one, that how will they undergo the test? You can't pressurize anyone. Tomorrow, say this person has led the test. Why? You are laying an allegation that he has had some extramarital sex. Let's do an STD test. How can you do? So for that also, you require four witnesses. But for rape is different. Rape, a lady is saying that man has done zina bil jabr. She herself is a solitary witness. In this case, DNA testing can be the solitary proof along with other evidence. But for adultery or fornication, four witnesses yet a must. And that's what I mentioned in the Sharia. Hope that answers the question, sister.